Hey, Dr. Barry here. In this video, I want to teach you just about everything you need to know about magnesium and what you can do about it. Did you know there's a greater than 50% chance that you are deficient in magnesium sitting there right now? Yeah, that's right. And low magnesium is one of the leading causes of heart attack in the modern world. So this is a big deal. You need to pay attention, okay? Before we get into this, I want you to take 1 second, please, and hit the subscribe button right down there and hit the little bell. So every time I get a bright idea, you'll be one of the very first to know, okay? Please subscribe. It helps me spread this word to people who need it. Now, let's talk about magnesium, what it is, why it's important, and what you can do to keep your levels optimized, okay? Like I said, greater than 50% of the population of the modern world, if you eat the standard American diet, greater than 50% chance that you're deficient, okay? And that's a big medical deal. That's not trivial. That's very important. If every study that's done about people who've had a myocardial infarction, a heart attack, shows that they're much more likely to have low levels of magnesium than people who didn't have a heart attack. So this is very important to keep you healthy and keep you running and gunning, as I say in the clinic, because that's what we're after here. Now, what are the symptoms of having low or deficient magnesium? It's a long list. Some of them are kind of generalized, systemic, and others are very specific, okay? If you have just daily fatigue, you can have low magnesium. That's one of the things it can cause. If you just chronically have a low or depressed mood, that could be from low magnesium. Your brain and your heart absolutely have to have the right levels of magnesium in order to have optimal performance. If you have muscle cramps in the middle of the night, you're almost guaranteed to have low or deficient magnesium. So if you have to jump up in the middle of the night and grab your leg and do the cramp dance, you need some sort of magnesium either in your diet or a supplement. And we'll get to that in a minute. At the end, I'm going to tell you the supplements I recommend and actually include links. So stay tuned for that. So what about constipation? Yeah, if you're chronically on the constipation side of the spectrum, you probably need more magnesium in your diet. If you have trouble getting to sleep or staying asleep, yes, insomnia, that's one of the things that low magnesium can cause, okay? If you have high blood pressure or hypertension, one of the things that can help to lower it naturally is a magnesium supplement, and that's been shown in multiple medical studies, okay? So what are the causes? How do people get low magnesium? The number one most common cause is there's just not enough magnesium in the standard American diet or the standard Western diet, the standard low-fat, high-carb, lots of whole grains. There's just not enough magnesium in there for the human body to receive optimal levels. If you take acid blockers of any kind, if you take proton pump inhibitors or H2 blockers or just over-the-counter acid absorbers or blockers, then you're probably deficient in magnesium. The acid in your stomach is actually supposed to be there. Who knew, right? You're supposed to be very, very acidic down in your stomach. That's how you absorb many of the minerals that you need. And so if you're taking a daily Prilosec, Omeprazole, Prevacid, Nexium, if you do that every day without thinking, then you're not absorbing magnesium and many other minerals you need, and it can lead to very severe long-term disease. So if you're doing that, stop that. There are other medicines that can lead to magnesium deficiency, some of the antibiotics, some of the birth control, some of the blood pressure control medicines. If you have a question about a medicine you specifically are taking, leave a comment down below. I try to answer every comment. So just comment me your medicine and how much you take of it a day, and I'll tell you if that might be leading to magnesium deficiency. Now, do we need to get tested for this? This is a huge area of controversy. There is a serum magnesium test. And back when I was first starting to look for mineral and vitamin deficiencies, I thought, well, that we'll check that and see. But here's the problem with just checking a serum magnesium. Your body is so hardwired to keep your magnesium in the blood exactly where it needs to be, because if it's not right, you quickly develop a heart problem and you quickly die. And so there are not many people around who have a chronically low serum magnesium. That just doesn't happen. So if you checked 1,000 people's serum magnesium, it's going to be normal 99.999% of the time, unless they're in the ICU or the CCU or they're very, very ill. So you could have a severe depletion of magnesium in your overall body, but your serum magnesium be normal. That's absolutely possible. I see that every day in the clinic. So for a while, I read about RBC magnesium, or the magnesium on red blood cells, and that was the secret to fine deficiency. Well, I started checking a lot of those. It's more expensive to check that test, and not all insurances pay for it, but I checked enough of them to see that they're all normal, just like the serum magnesium. And that's because the body so tightly regulates magnesium that you're just not going to find it that way. Where you're going to find it was back up where I started with the symptoms. Okay, so I don't routinely order any extra testing for magnesium. Serum magnesium is just part of my overall panel in my clinic, but I don't do any out of the way testing for magnesium because you're just not going to find it, because it's not compatible with life. If you have a low serum or RBC magnesium, you can't live for long with that. So extra testing is just really not needed for this. So how do we fix it? How do you fix magnesium deficiency or suboptimal levels? Number one, and some of you may not be ready for this, is by eating the right food. Okay, that's going to always be my number one answer, right? You've already figured that out. You need to be eating your greens. Leafy green vegetables are the number one source of magnesium in the human diet. You don't like greens, you say? Shut up. Eat your greens, okay? Grow up. Now, if you're 12 years old, you maybe can get by with that. Oh, I don't like my greens. Mm-mm. If you're a grown person, shut up. Eat your greens, okay? Learn to like them. Put some salt on them. Put some pepper on them. Put some olive oil on them. Put whatever. I don't care. Shut up and eat your greens. That's very important. If you want to be healthy, if you want to be vigorous and robust and vigorous and potent, you need to eat your greens every day, okay? Not optional. Number two is nuts and seeds. Most nuts and seeds have a good little dose of magnesium in them. They also have good fats. They're very good for you. I recommend that you have some nuts and seeds every day. Avocado is a fruit that's very, very good source of magnesium. Not as good as leafy greens, but still pretty good. And then egg yolks have a little bit of magnesium. I love egg yolks, and so I always have to mention those. They don't have nearly as much as leafy greens, so you can forget that. As a replacement for your leafy greens, you have to eat your leafy greens. Then chocolate. A lot of people, when they're really down and moody, they crave chocolate. And a lot of experts think that this is why you're craving the magnesium that good quality chocolate has in it. I'm not talking about the stupid cheap milk chocolate. That has no magnesium. That has nothing but sugar. Okay. So no, not talking about that. I'm talking about the bitter, real good quality, usually more expensive chocolates. They have a goodly little amount of magnesium in them. So those are the best ways to get magnesium. And the number one best way being eat your leafy greens. Shut up. Just do that. Okay. Now, a lot of people just say, yeah, I'm going to eat my leafy greens, but also I feel better when I take a magnesium supplement. I don't cramp as often. My mood's better. I have more energy. And this is one of the few times when I say, yeah, that's fine. Take a magnesium supplement. There are about 10 different kinds. A few, if you take enough of them to replace magnesium, you're going to have loose stools or diarrhea. So the two that I recommend are magnesium citrate and magnesium glycinate. They may be just a smidge more expensive, but not much, and they're worth the money. I've got links to just a couple of them. I don't recommend any specific brand. As you come to know me, you'll know I don't recommend pills, powders, products. I don't do that. I don't endorse things to try to get a kickback. That's not my style. But I just included a couple of links just to the cheaper ones you can get off Amazon that will do just fine. Another great way to get it is with Epsom salts, Epsom salt baths. That's magnesium. Is what that is. And so my wife, when she gets home from a long shift on labor and delivery hall, she'll take a Epsom salt bath and put some essential oils in there. And that hot water opens up her pores and allows her to absorb a lot of that magnesium. And she feels better after that. And that's another great natural way to get it. I'll put a link to some just any Epsom salt bath will do, but I'll just link to one so you can just click on it. So again, very, very important. Magnesium is a big deal. That's why I wanted to do a video about this. By keeping your magnesium optimized, you can absolutely lower your risk of a fatal heart attack. proven science. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. Any cardiologist will tell you that that's the case. Okay. Now, if this felt like good content to you, something that you can apply immediately to your life, or you can share with a friend or relative, then please share this. Share this on your social media. Share it on Facebook so that your friends and family can reap the benefits of this information. I do this to help people, and I need you to help me help them. Okay. This is Dr. Berry. I'll see you next time.